can run on for a long time, run on for a long time, run on for a long time. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down. Sooner or later, gotta cut you down.
Hey everyone, this is Abra, and I'm back to give my two cents on Wraith of God. Wraith of God is the latest graphic novel release from beloved comic veteran Aaron LaCresti, whose body of work includes notable titles with both Marvel and DC Comics. Wraith of God tells the story of a mysterious Avenger who acts as the righteous hand of God, delivering justice to the evil creatures plaguing the Old West. The Wraith is also a master of illusion and disguise, and uses these skills to track down his targets. A bit of the Lone Ranger, a splash of the Shadow, the Wraith exhibits stoicism similar to Batman.
I'm Batman.
While administering God's justice, he's well acquainted with the evil that lurks within the hearts of men.
Who knows what evil lurks in the hearts of men?
But he has been tasked with a greater responsibility, that of eradicating the vile supernatural beings wreaking havoc across the wild frontier. The mysterious Wraith and his faithful companion Esther each have well thought out backstories. At different points in the book, readers come to discover the tragic pasts of both characters, which cause their destinies to collide. Aaron did an excellent job of making these characters feel fleshed out and relatable, all despite inhabiting this supernatural version of the past. I always find Western settings for stories to be quite appealing. That period is just so rough and untamed. The opportunities during that period seemed endless, just as long as those living out there had the grit to overcome the numerous hardships. The inclusion of supernatural beings during this period just makes everything that more dangerous and intriguing. The Wraith's design has a classic feel to it, reminiscent to that of other fictional Western vigilantes, such as the Lone Ranger or Zorro. His costume has that simple yet imposing feel. I felt the main character having a divine purpose gave the story more weight. The Wraith isn't out for revenge, as with many other dark Avenger tales. His is a much higher calling. The fact that he's looking for redemption is compelling as well. However, the mysterious Wraith is flawed and capable of sin, just like everyone else, which is demonstrated in the story. Wraith of God begins with the main character having tracked down a pack of werewolves. The group is on the hunt for a magical amulet which makes the wearer impervious to death while in their wolf form. The hero is able to make quick work of the pack, but unfortunately, one of the members manages to escape during the fight. This leads the Wraith and Esther to the town of Calamity, Arizona, a place filled with all sorts of interesting and unsavory individuals. Here, readers get to see some of the Wraith's many talents on display as he attempts to track down not only the elusive werewolf, but the amulet as well. I very much enjoyed how Aaron gave the Wraith layers of complexity. As the story progresses, we learn about his intriguing past and come to discover that the character is quite intelligent. Not only does he exhibit stoicism and cunning like that of the Caped Crusader, he shares another trait with Batman, an in-depth knowledge of science. Aaron has crafted a terrific story with Wraith of God. His years of experience with the Big Two have allowed him to really sharpen his skills. The blending of Western, supernatural, and religious themes come together to create a very interesting and rich tale. Not only did Aaron expertly craft his story, but he put that same care and attention to detail into the artwork as well. And the beautiful colors by Gabe El-Tayeb help give the Wraith of God that classic feel. Another interesting thing that Aaron is doing with the Wraith's story is making it part of a larger connected universe. Readers get a small taste of this in the conclusion of the graphic novel. I'm excited to see how Aaron will weave everything together. For those who might have missed out on the first issue of Wraith of God, fear not, Aaron is set to launch the campaign for the second issue very soon. This is a series that readers won't want to miss out on. Well, that's my two cents on The Wraith of God by Aaron LaPresti. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, take care.